There should be a law forbidding doctors from falling sick.
Medical emergency in town. The doctor there is sick. I'll be back soon. If he dies, I won't be returning. I'll have to replace him.
In spite of Dr. Beaupré's goodwill, the place didn't look much like a physician's office. It could easily be mistaken for a sewing shop. The good doctor, flanked by his beautiful spouse. Pure happiness, captured on cardstock. Carl recognized this woman's soulful eyes. Was it Dr. Beaupré, who had hit him head on at the village border?
Unknown woman. I never did quite catch her name. The men called her Laurie. She had neck wound. There was so much blood. A bullet had done a lot of damage, probably hitting the cerebellum. It was hopeless. She had a cardiac arrest. The man had found her like this, he said. I doubt it. But in a small town like this, it's usually best to turn a blind eye. I've been been told to step back from sending out the death certificate. This whole thing sickens me. Rosaire Armin. No medical explanation whatsoever can explain why old Rosaire is still alive. As we in the trade say, the only way to cure him is to kill him.
Doctors used light reflecting frontal mirrors to look inside the patient's cavities. That was a bit unsettling, but back then it was pretty much always the case with medicine. Dr. Beaupré had done his medical studies quite far from here. He was surely one of the first students out of the new campus to settle on the mountainside. For the one-eyed, or for other vision problems, the eye patch was the way to go. Carl got the trembles as he imagined the excruciating pain that kind of scalpel could no doubt inflict. Within these miserable walls, patients probably felt more like in a slaughterhouse than in a doctor's office. Chamber pot. Fortunately for Carl, inspecting it wouldn't further this particular investigation. A communist manifesto. Only a few years ago, this type of allegiance meant prison time, and even at present, the Western world was very wary of the Soviet threat. Why would the doctor own such a book? Nobody kills a rich patient to start a revolution. It didn't make any sense. He had to dig deeper still to understand. Luckily, that was Carl Faubert's specialty.
Communist Manifest. The history of all hitherto existing society is the history of class struggles. Freeman and slave, patrician and plebeian, lord and servant, guild master and journeyman. In a word, oppressor and oppressed, stood in constant opposition to one another, carried on an uninterrupted, now hidden, now open fight. A fight that each time ended either in a revolutionary reconstitution of society at large or in the common ruin of the contending classes. In earlier epochs of history, we find almost everywhere the complicated arrangement of society into various orders and manifold gradation of social rank. In ancient Rome, we have patricians, knights, plebeians, slaves. In the Middle Ages, feudal lords, vassals, guild masters, journeymen, apprentices, serfs, and almost all of these classes, again, subordinate gradations.
Someone had lost a few liters of blood here. Carl's first thought had been a lumber accident, someone's hand cut by a saw, or a hunting accident. In any case, whoever had lost all this blood couldn't have gone far. Perhaps they were already dead. Great care had to be taken searching this place full of oddities. Everything was important. The decor itself told a story.
Oh, mon bonhomme!
Cette falole est drôle.
Je m'attendais pas à ce qu'un étrange retentisse par ici. Moi te dire, je prends plus de chance depuis que ça rôde dans ce bout-là. J'ai ma carabine au bout du doigt, et puis bang, 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 si ça s'approche! Si tu veux du linge chaud, parce que t'es habillé comme un gars de la ville, je dirais pas non à une bonne bouteille de caribou. Puis tu pigeras ce que tu voudras parmi mes guenilles. Oyez, 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 il y a un petit gars d'écarté dans ma maison. Hé, la Corriveau, Batèche, ça te passe l'envie de te marier, la Corriveau? À tuer tous ses maris, squeak, les uns après les autres. Pas de pitié dans le mariage. Hé, la Corriveau, Batèche, ça te passe l'envie de te marier, la Corriveau? À tuer tous ses maris, squeak, les uns après les autres. Pas de pitié dans le mariage. Touche pas à ça, l'enfant, tu pourrais te faire mal. Ben oui, une couche. Tu peux-tu tout faire en même temps, toi? Gomme-moi la belle rose de la tuyau, qui se donne au yob sur le mercredi des cendres. Fais-tu pas effrayant, cette histoire-là? Vois-tu le livre, là? C'est le Wendigo. Ouais, le Wendigo. Un guerrier qui devient un loup pour se venger de sa grosse peine. Et...
Tales and Legends, page 1. There was a time when hate waged war. Our hunters could decimate the great wolves who had taken our children. Our warriors snapped the necks of the cowards who had reached for our supplies. The deafening sound of rock and bone breaking was enough to satiate the
hate, ouais,
and the rivers of blood would express our remorse and apologies. Thus was balance maintained. Then came the whites. The legend of Wendigo dates back to a time before what anyone but the tallest trees can remember. A time of great cold and great aspiration.
Tu marches, tu
and the
marches,
ships came
tu marches,
and
spewed
men
des pieds.
And their fire cannons, plagues and spinelessness. Balance broke forever. The dead were piling up on our ancestral lands. Too many bodies covered in moss. Too much blood spilled on our stone. Our bone breaking hate did not suffice.
D'apparence que mon caribou tarde.
Tales and Legends, page 2. One day, a young warrior who had lost everything, nieces, brothers, parents, and hope, fell to his knees in the middle of a small clearing, covered in the blood of his fiancée, killed after having crossed the path of some whites passing by.
Je vais finir par te charger l'usure du plancher.
The great spirit called out to him words that came so naturally to him. Words that could only create a great river of blood and guts, and a terrifying roar of screams. He called out to him for a force that no one had before. He became Wendigo. The whites were decimated under the icy claws of the Wendigo. The great tide of blood even pushed a few ships back out to sea.
D'apparence que mon caribou tarde.
Vengeance, for as long as the heart of one of his famous murderers still beat on free territory, he would prevail. H3. The elders say that it was the force the ancestors returned to the nature that turned the young warrior, This clearing, where many ancestors had been buried in centuries past, clearing now covered in blood, spilled unjustly in the
town. Oye, oye, oye! Il y a un chico de quartier dans ma maison!
Ancestors heard the cries of the young warrior. Only a remarkable time like this could the Wendigo have been born. His vengeance satiated, the warrior became Wendigo, went to rest forever. His frozen heart melted and disappeared. Much like
tu marches, tu marches, tu marches, tu sens des pieds.
The fall of the tree lands for you as well. There was much celebration. Balance had been restored, but the whites came back too. White hatred is never satisfied by rock and bone turned to dust. They arrived by the hundreds, armed with guns and torches,
burned
every village, raped every woman, smashed the head of every newborn, tortured every man that fell into their grips. Never before had unbalance been so deep for the Cree people, and ever since it has been told that one should be satisfied with the rivers of blood brought by hatred. Despite the wrongfulness done to them, because remarkable hate comes at far too steep a price.
When they
in the hearts of the Cree people remained fear. One day a young warrior would once again call out with the remarkable hate, because they know wisdom brought by this legend, the Wendigo would prevail, but that this victory would come at great cost. The whites would come back, the whites would rule, none would be spared.
Oye, 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 y'a un petit gars d'écarté dans ma maison! Oh, la belle pétarade! En 17 que c'était! Et le Kaiser, il se souvient de moi avec ma belle carabine! Et bang bang que je lui disais! Bang bang bang! Le bon temps. Vois que t'as pas mieux à faire.
Forgotten the harsh reality that his body also needed nourishment, especially in the dead of winter.
Thank you.
It was so cold, already Carl did not feel his toes anymore. Shivered as he saw the emblem. The Patriot flag, used during the 1837 rebellion, and which had resurfaced in 1970s Quebec, flown proudly by the FLQ terrorist groups. This flag meant bombs, kidnappings, threats in the papers. It was a sign of rebellion. The place looked more like a pigsty than a house. A heavy stench of curdled milk, cheap alcohol, and boiled cauliflower filled the air. Music invaded the minds of men even in the remotest of places. The man didn't own a turntable though, so there's that going for him. Back then, in Africa and elsewhere, people were ready to take up arms to stand against the yoke of English imperialism. In Montreal, mailboxes were blown up, abductions were carried out, and violent manifestos were distributed to media outlets. But around here, in the great northernmost, all a man could do is curse out loud against a faraway evil and pray for the revolution to arise. That man, by any reckoning, was from that very stock.
No, combat liberation will happen by force or not at all. We will prevail.
The rag reeked of fermented vomit. Carl wondered how one could bear to live in such gross and horrid conditions. Régin Blouin. Seems like that pig had a name after all. You had to be out of your mind to cook up white whiskey at home. The all-surrounding stench of alcohol alone was probably enough to gas a man to death. You had to be out of your mind to cook up white whiskey at home. The all-surrounding stench of alcohol alone was probably enough to gas a man to death. If Carl had at any point wished to get his hands on some caribou, he couldn't have wished for better than a distillery like this one. An axe, not too shabby. Carl felt he needed to protect himself. You had to be out of your mind to cook up white whiskey at home. The all-surrounding stench of alcohol alone was probably enough to gas a man to death. Carl, like many of his contemporaries, felt like he had more trouble breathing when he wasn't smoking. Cigarette was his own personal breathing assistant. Carl now knew how to quench the drunkard's thirst.
Caribou traditional recipe. White whiskey, too much isn't a valid quantifier for that. Sherry wine, for added mellowness.
The rag reeked of fermented vomit. Carl wondered how one could bear to live in such gross and horrid conditions. Had obviously seen its share of gravel roads. Carl wasn't a mechanic, but he could easily tell that only the most heartfelt prayer would bring this old beater back from its slumber. With that cold, however, it was more likely that it would wait until next spring to wake up.
Un bon gallon de caribou, puis on devient amis. Sinon, mon petit gars, tu sors avant que je te sorte. T'apparences que mon caribou tarde. Oyez, 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 il y a un petit gars d'écarté dans ma maison. Thank you.
I'd seen the girl from the car somewhere. Same picture with at the doctor's office. I need to figure out what this all means. Would this be enough to posit that the doctor is the melancholic and that the melancholic is the reckless driver? Elementary in my dear journal. In the box I found a state affair, no less. I wouldn't want to expose some shady activity by enemy of democracy. Still need to figure out why the hell this message ended up in the doctor's hands. Reckless driver was definitely a fugitive running from the scene of the crime, still covered in Hamilton's blood. What a mess. Isabel's picture being in the reckless driver's car suggests Dr. Beaupré has something to do with all of this. All that's left is to figure out his exact role. It's never good to disclose communist ties in a small village like this, where established order is fiercely defended. Was it only intellectual curiosity on the doctor's part or actual convictions? Jean's Lachon went to the doctor's. Now I need to know if the doctor saw Gilles. I know how to lead to perfect investigation. Jean Bouin has clear ties to the FOQ, a revolutionary for justice and freedom. Might as well say it here. It seems like a perfectly imperfect fit for the savagely capitalistic dreams of a rich Anglophone. And today, the village's rich Anglophone was killed. This file seems incomplete. Who is this pre-woman? And what happened to her? Everything points to a certain death, but no death certificate. I'm a doctor, but I know fresh blood when I see it. Someone bled profusely in this office. Less than 2 days ago. Nothing weird about that. Unless. Rosaire, a According to his medical file, this Great War veteran is an immortal soldier, retired in the North, that even alcohol and tobacco can't kill. As dashing as he was in his youth, in spite of that, he doesn't have all his wits about him anymore. It has its benefits. We can ask anything from him, provided that we bring him alcohol. He agrees to help me. Jean-Paul, this man is a crook. I know scoundrels like him. They only care about the laws they can break and they'd be violent. Surely it is a real one. It seems something terrible happened to her. Her case is shrouded in mystery. I bet a bottom dollar she wasn't from around here. Needs more research.
Felt that it was mission accomplished with the wicked nectar in his hands.
Critique de mon caribou pour revenir de même.
Ah, quand on cherche, on trouve. Parce que je t'aime bien, Astor, je vais te dire quelque chose. Tu fais bien de prendre ma pélisse. Parce que par là-bas, tu vas rencontrer le vrai froid. Un froid qui glace comme t'en as jamais connu dans ta vie.
C'est encore beau. Tout ce qui est vieilli est bien meilleur. C'est encore beau. Tout ce qui est vieilli est bien meilleur. Gomme-moi la belle rose là-dessus, qui se donne au yob sur le mercredi des cendres. Si tu peux effrayer cette histoire. Touche pas à ça, l'enfant, tu pourrais te faire mal. Touche pas à ça, l'enfant, tu pourrais te faire mal. Touche pas à ça, l'enfant, tu pourrais te faire mal. Ben oui, une couche. Tu peux-tu tout faire en même temps, toi? Dans mon temps, c'était comme sur l'image. On était vrais, fiers, forts, puis on avait le bon lieu de notre bord. Cadon, ça ouvre l'appentis. Prends-la, je m'en fous. Perds ton temps dans mes déchets tant que tu rapportes du caribou. Thank you.
his cabin had been very generous to Carl. He couldn't have asked for more.